okay? We did what we needed to do. Step close, and throw. There you go, bro. You never know who's gonna show up.
Good hips, great hips that time.
All right, that's when you know your discipline. I remember coming out here when I used to work out, man, and all I had was the Thompson pad, but it was Roland High School in California. That's what I threw to. Seriously, or I'd hang a tire from the goalpost off a rope and I'd throw to that. Whatever I had to do to get better, right? As quarterbacks, man, everyone else isn't gonna work as hard as you all the time. They don't all have side coaches. You know what I mean? They go to their team practice, work as hard as they can, and they think that's enough. And for some of them, maybe it is, but not for the quarterbacks. Do these things on our own like this, we're gonna be great. If we're gonna demand greatness from our receivers, you gotta get there, you gotta give me 10 and work back. If I'm gonna demand greatness from my linemen, man, you gotta give me time. We need 3 more seconds here, right? I need time. We got 1 minute left in the game. We're going deep. I need you guys to block a little harder. You can demand that when you demand it from yourself, and they'll see that, okay? Once you're the hardest worker on the field, you're in charge. You have the right, you have the excuse to go and tell everybody how they need to play if they're not getting it done. He ain't working hard enough, you can tell him because you are. You understand that? If you ain't working, you ain't giving that extra, you don't have the right. That's not an option no more, and they'll call you out on it, okay? But every time you work harder than everybody else, brother, you have a chance to help everybody get a little bit better and push them, all right? And they'll remember you the rest of your life for it, too. Give us a break, man. A lot of pride.
Coach, you're on three, coach, you're on me. 1, 2, 3.
Coach,
on!
Good. Nice shot. There you go, good. There you go, work it. Put yourself in a situation. Put yourself in a situation. So stay climbing. Keep that flat. Have that plant. Boom. Just glide. Boom. Upstairs. I don't know why I got it. Okay? Let's go here. Up. Hold. Hips. Nice. Connor. Excellent. There you go. Eyes, eyes, eyes. Come down. Back. Yes, sir. Still a threat. Drive it. Is that every time we show up here, we have a plan. And everyone's plan is going to be a little different. Maybe this guy wants to work on alignment. Maybe this guy's got to work on his eyes. Maybe this guy's got to work balance. Maybe this guy's got to work on his follow through. Everybody's going to have a different plan.
Say go.
Yes. Good. Line and rim. Oh. Line, rim. Good. Get him. Good. Get him. Hold your. So you come here willing to get better at something, okay? Every time you come here and have that plan. Talk to your parents about it. Talk to your dad about it on your way here. Remind yourself, make a note. All of those things, those are what the elite guys do. They have a goal board, man. And every day they check it. They check it every single day because they know 99% of the other guys ain't got it. Hi everybody, my name is Mike Hohensee. Everyone calls me Coach Ho. I coach quarterbacks and receivers locally here in Chicago. And my accolades, if you want to call them accolades, I'm in 4 Hall of Fames, high school, junior college, and professionally. I've coached all pros, I've coached all state kids, I've coached kids that are in youth football all the way through the professional level. And I think I do a good job not only managing their technique, but managing them playing the position, understanding who they are when they step out of the door of their house every day, and what they're going through, even sometimes when they go back to their own homes. Okay, so I think with me, you're getting more than a guy that can just teach your kid to catch a ball or throw a spiral. I'm teaching the kid the game of football, and hopefully at the same time helping him with life as well.